What is the secret of colors? And what revelation does it contain about you and how to live a blessed life? What makes colors? Why is red red? Why is blue blue? Why is yellow yellow? Why is black that I'm wearing? Why is it black? Why? Well, the answer is in the principle of physics. It has to do with the physical world. But could this actually give a law of life, the way God made this creation, about how to live a blessed life in the spiritual? And the Book of Mysteries is a mystery called The Secret of Colors. The teacher leads the disciple into a garden filled with flowers. It had to be one of the most beautiful places in the whole premises. So many colors. The teacher says, what do you see?
Flowers. Red, blue, purple, yellow, green, almost every color.
Mm-hmm. And why is that red flower red?
Well, that's the color. What do you mean?
Well, the teacher says the red flower is bathed in the light of all colors. See, it absorbs all colors, but red is the color of the one light it doesn't receive, it doesn't absorb, it doesn't keep. So red is the one color it reflects and gives back. So if a flower took in and kept all the colors of light, what color would it be? It would be dark. It would be black. See, what makes something red or green or yellow? Is because that's the one color that object does not keep. Not just with flowers, but with everything. You see, here's the spiritual law. That which you take from this world and keep to yourself is not that which you are. It's that which you are not. See, people think, you know, if I get more, I'm gonna be rich, I'm gonna be so full. No. That which you keep, you have to have, is that which you're empty of. Those who take from this world and don't give, they're the ones who are empty. That's why they have to keep taking and taking and taking. Those who have to get love from everybody, acceptance from everybody, they're not the ones who are loved. They're the ones who don't have it. That's why they're needy. That's why they have to keep getting it. And those who seek to get blessed from the world, but they don't bless, they're not the blessed, they're the unblessed. It's like the black flowers. It doesn't matter how much they have. It doesn't matter how much you have. You see, that which you keep is what you don't have in the kingdom. That which you give is what you have. That which you give is what you are or what you will become. Those who give love are those who are loved. Those who give of their possessions, give away, they're the ones who are rich. And those who bless are the blessed. So that which you would have your life become is the very thing you have to give. You see, Messiah said, give, it shall be given to you. Whatever you give, whatever you bless with, you shall be. So live a life of blessing, of love, of giving, of your possessions, and you'll be rich. Live a life of blessing others. Set your heart not on getting, but of giving, and you'll always, always be blessed. Because the light shines on every flower, on every object. But each flower or object only becomes the light that it gives back. God's love shines on all of us. It's shining on you. But only that which you give back is what you are and will become. The more you give, the more you become. So whatever you would want, whatever you need, give it. Whatever you would become, set your life to be a vessel of one who gives that to everyone. What happens to those who keep nothing but give everything back? They become light. Around the time of the Exodus, all of a sudden, Egypt, at the peak of its power, suddenly collapses, never to rise again.